Requesting SITREP. Roger, Ghost Wing Control. We're just making sure everything's okay in this sector. We need you further up north. We're under caution. Roger. Control, this is Charlie 17. We got a problem here. Go ahead, Byrne. We've got a group of blokes refusing to stand down here. Potential 315. Roger, we'll send for backup. Colonel, hang on! They're turning violent! It's the fascists! All units, respond to Charlie 17. Go, go, go!
And so I am here again. James Byrne on a journey through the realm of heaven. In the time before this time, our Aerospace Strike Force vanquished the Project 10. And in the midst of it all, I was leading the Sky Phoenix team to create an orbital solar power plant, which coincided with a war in space across the Pacific. Before moving on to the next phase of life during the new war, I had joined Taranis Aviation International in a dutiful pledge to combat the new threat facing my homeland. And so I returned to our once glorious journey with every intention of enacting a great mission. But Project 10 had not left their colluding allies unprotected. We would soon stand before a force led by a ruthless tyrant, an army of thieves, and a malevolent trailblazer. And now the noble Taranis must face a new, formidable, yet familiar adversary. During the last war, I was being targeted by Russian hitmen, sent directly from the Kremlin themselves. After the dust had finally settled, it seems I've managed to shake off the enemy, but not without a sacrifice. During the last battle of Carinya, my close friend Chris Nesbitt Windhover, after suffering from poisonous aftereffects of a bioweapon attack, made one last stand towards the leader of Project 10. Only when his enemy had fallen did he finally give in to death. After his burial in his old hometown of Winton, he leaves behind a legacy, an army of friends, and a clue. This was one of his homes, the one he had spent in bed overcoming a sickness before working with Taranis. He told me there was something inside that would help me on my journey without him. As I had expected. A treasure drove full of things that could help me on my way, including a code book. Ah, yes. This is a code book that Ashling Lotus gave to me. A journey where he would be still guiding me from the afterlife, hopefully. As long as there's a light, his shadow will be over me. But no need to worry about that now. Time to go to the internship. I took this internship at Skymasters directly after Sky Phoenix. We were a few brave university students willing to challenge conventional thought and take part in the crucial first step in the exploration of the solar system. But the Prime Minister's plans to materialize and industrialize Earth's orbit sparked an arms race in space that eclipsed the darkest and most terrifying days of the Cold War. Before we could prevent it, my team and I were caught in the center of battle, a battle that threatened to become an all-out global war for control of space. And then there was the domestic affairs. Supporters from the Greens and ALP parties were dead set against this project, and protests went far out of control. This, combined with controversy surrounding recent coal mining, has caused some to go to the extreme, and civil unrest was on the rise. But now, I hope that after Election Day, this whole thing would eventually simmer down. Eventually, but not now, evidently.
Oh hey, Mr. Byrne.
Enjoying the internship, Jules?
Indeed. It is nice to settle down again. They've helped me greatly with my current predicament.
I heard you've now fully adjusted.
Yes. Living well is the best revenge. I see a jolly fine career taking place here, while still helping the RCAP and the Ghost Wing any way I can.
That was some damn good work you did on the radio with me during the Queensland policing.
Jules was a close friend of mine in the Royal Civil Air Patrol. He was leading the ground crew for Sky Phoenix, but things got out of control as the more radical of Green's activists stormed the area and clubbed him over the head. The trauma has made him blind as a result. I'm still quite angry at such an act of injustice.
Still, that little cock-up that night might have drawn some unfavorable attention. Neither of us are still safe.
Relax, man. Skymasters and my Taranis mates have arranged better protection.
Excuse me, Mr. Byrne. Dr. Horatio wishes to speak with you.
Oh, this must be in regard to the future. See you around, Jules.
Catch you around, James.
This new internship at Skymasters has led to several opportunities I could have only hoped for. Following the death of its founder, Dr. Jonathan Masters, the company's leadership fell mostly to Joe Torres, but the chief of aerospace engineering was always to be Captain Julio Horatio. Following the war in space, the Aerospace Strike Force scaled back its space operations to focus more on the Pacific War. As a result, however, Julio was an office guy now, handling the contracts and paperwork.
Ah, right on time as usual, Mr. Byrne. Dr. Horatio, you wanted to see me, sir? Yes, I heard you were targeted again. Well, not really targeted. It was just a bunch of guys wanting a shove. But it did escalate quite a bit. Not helped at all by your response. I understand that you're feeling vengeful after what the more radical activists did to your friends. Trust me, I am mad at them too. But I thought we had a handle on what you guys did in the dark, as well as the maverick attitude that even Windhover continues to keep to this day. Do you have any idea what kind of money Skymasters is going to have to lay out to keep these sons of bitches from filing subpoenas against you?
A lot?
Yep, for any political figures, perhaps a 6-figure tax-free settlement, and potentially more security if the radicals get more coordinated.
Ouch.
Yeah, ouch. Look, I went to bat for you with Torres and his people for this internship. They admired your mates, but didn't always see eye to eye with them. And they aren't going to be pleased. They're already sticking our necks out for you guys following the Sky Phoenix project, but we just can't afford any more controversy. Even with the ALP and the Greens off our backs.
So, am I out?
Do not take this personally, Jim. It was a very difficult decision. I don't normally do this stuff, but I'm still a part of your team, and I still owe Ashling a great deal for saving me. So, I'll give you a one-time severance package. There, don't waste it.
A Pacifica flight ticket? Money? Passport? What are you doing this for?
Go spend some time in Bali, or whatever's left of Indonesia after the war. Hang with some people. Take some time to get your head screwed on straight before you restart uni. Just don't plan on blowing the next 40 years playing around in the sand, okay?
I'll be a good boy, Dr. Horatio. I promise I won't cause any more trouble.
See that you don't. But I hope you don't mind if I don't hold my breath on that promise, because I don't hear any ice freezing in hell yet.
I guess Horatio must have sent me here for a reason. Otherwise, he would be cruel to send me to a country whose collapse I might have contributed to. Indonesia, and even Bali, had been the site of several unexpected events during the invasion. The people who gained power afterward welcomed the Communist Rabat Foundation into their territory to continue their global conquest. Their mistake, as even after the Iron War, Rabat remnants continued to hold onto their power. They used the increasing industrialism and declining stability to their advantage. Finally, one last war in the Pacific saw the opposition launch a counter-coup, removing the Ludyatkovist scourge from the Republic. leaving behind only the scattered pieces of Indonesia. I'm still not sure how my uncle in West Papua manages to survive. To avoid total breakdown, various territories in Indonesia had to rearrange themselves into semi-autonomous regions. Bali was one of them. So when people see a holiday destination here, an island paradise teeming with wonders of Indonesia, I see that too.
Hello, what's your story?
Access code Exodus 108.
Good evening. I'm Samantha Cypress. My friends call me Sam. I'm the Pharaoh's daughter. Come to pull your basket out of the Nile.
Oh, and you know I'm being tagged, right?
Oh, yes, buddy. That you are. It's the Indonesian BIN. They're looking for you. And also, the Russian SVR is onto you, too. Man, you are unlucky today. Luckily for both of us, Bali's quite a haystack.
Even so, I'm still a mouse being chased by cats.
Indeed. There's a taxi inbound to take you to my hotel suite. You'll be safe there.
Then what?
You'll get ready for your flight out. What else?
And what'll you be up to?
I'm gonna keep chilling out here. They'll never catch me.
Ah, Mr. Byrne, how nice of you to join us this fine evening. I am Lieutenant Mark Stamford, and you will be my passenger tomorrow afternoon. So, here is our flight plan. It's gonna be a long one, but I personally am used to that. How about you?
Okay, so tomorrow afternoon we will be leaving Bali in the Challenger and proceeding to take a wide turn up to Colombo Airport. We have to avoid Singapore because the International Space Elevator there is still being occupied by the Chinese. Nobody goes into the international airport or through the Strait of Malacca without their permission. And so we will go up to the hangar that we purchased in Samarkand, Uzbekistan. And then we will go on the long march across the Caspian, through to Turkey, and then turn into Egypt, right to the Air Force base in Masa Matru, assuming it's not still under attack. And then, well, after picking up cargo in Samarkand, we will go all the way up to our base of operations in Solistia Gumeshti, Romania. Sounds like a flight plan, doesn't it?
Now, we need to be at the airport at the designated time, or else there's a serious risk that the State Intelligence Agency will be on our asses. All right, till then. Sleep well.
Nighty-night.
Neura ground, this is Bombardier Echo Juliet Oscar Romeo Lima Alpha with Alpha. Request taxi for takeoff, west departure. Bombardier Echo Juliet Oscar Romeo Lima Alpha, taxi 2 and hold short of runway 9er, using taxiway November 6, November 7. Contact tower on 1181 when ready. Taxi 2 and hold short runway 9er, using taxiway November 6, November 7, Bombardier Oscar Romeo Lima Alpha.
Not a nice day for flying, so it seems, but we've got to get out of here as quickly as possible. The State Intelligence Agency's right on the doorstep. Crafty bastards.
Alright,
farewell, chaps.
Have fun explaining how you lost us.
Greetings, Ibis.
General Langham, my pleasure.
So, how have you been?
Well, my desk job is fine, but I'm not doing as much flying anymore.
Our Space Force is currently grounded for re-evaluation following the Space War and the last Battle of Carinia. How about you?
My force is now fully set up in Romania, and a liaison for the Polish president is currently approaching us for potential cooperation.
Did Exodus work?
Oh, like a charm. He's on his way. So, what's flying today?
Not much. Most combat squadrons in the Pacific War are moving up to RAAF Sugar and other northern bases for the time being. Windhover Squadron, the Woomer team, the lot. We're left here to test a new weapon.
I've been hearing about this weapon, but what is it?
Behold, my friend, the Sky Master's MQ-79A Cyclone, a new type of stealth drone for the new decade.
Oh wow.
Its autonomous flight navigation and general airframe is exported from our aerospace friends in Korea. It's tech of the craziest kind. The skin is protected from radar by a special coating made by Silver Sun Incorporated. That stuff's not cheap, but it's a lot less expensive than most other stealth materials on the market.
Even after the intercorporate war, Silver Sun is still in business?
The rest of the airframe is also off the shelf, especially with its Honeywell TFE-731 engines that are more suited to a business jet. It's not designed for striking deep into enemy territory. It's meant to operate in a combat environment full of violently maneuvering aircraft using their radar and ECM like crazy. In that fight, it doesn't have to slide through the air. It just needs to be less visible and quieter than everything else. For you see, what sets this drone aside from the others is its ability to carry up to 10 AIM-120 advanced medium-range air-to-air missiles inside. It's designed with all this low-cost stuff for one reason. Spit out a lot of missiles for our fighter jocks to control with their own radar.
We started working on it immediately right after the Coalition sneak attack over the Exmouth Plateau in December of last year.
And if I remember that correctly, those Indonesian fighters surrounded two unfortunate RAAF Super Hornets, and the Flying Fortress almost wiped out Learmonth base. If Windhover's XF-111s didn't launch when they did, we'd still be fighting that war today.
We analyzed every piece of data we could get from the first fight. The Super Hornets ran out of missiles and options before the other side lost planes. If we were to face another enemy like that, we would need more missile platforms. Hence all the cost-effectiveness of this otherwise mighty bird.
So how many will the RAF receive?
None. Although we've built four of these, they've sought to develop Boeing Australia's drone, Loyal Wingman. Also, the Strike Force is currently flying its next generation of Stealth Hawks. Who would have thought that inexpensive drones with out-of-the-box thinking is actually a thing now? A trend.
A plan is being considered to have drones like these stored in regional airports across Queensland for defense. But that's just a passing thought.
Except these ones have the Skymaster's label on them.
That too. During, and as you can see after, the Queensland state government has been trying to smear the Halifax and Sky Phoenix names, with limited success. Good news as it may be that the Liberals are here to help us. Skymaster's name is still in the mud with the Senate and the ALP.
And so you thought of me and my little company.
The thought of selling them to Taranis did cross my mind.
How long till you work out all the kinks?
Not very long. This tech is pretty mature, especially since much of it is Korean UAV work.
Excellent. I love them. I will place my bid.
I knew you would. Let's just keep the upcoming 5th and 6th for posterity.
Too easy. Now let's talk about that new flight of XF-111 Supervox you guys made. I might need them too.
So, we finally arrived. After our long journey, allow me to be the first to welcome you to Solishtia Gumeshti Airport. You know, I expected it to be a bit more flashy. It was built around, actually, I don't know. Actually, not much is known about this base. It just used to be a former airbase, deep in the sticks of Romania. And that's all we know. But we've breathed new life into it. This is our base of operations now, what we call the scrapyard.
Ah, I see.
You see, my friend, we've watched this hangar. And inside, you'll find a lot of wondrous weapons. But as far as the locals know, we're just a private company with more cash reserves than business sense. So, yes, this is our new home, so it seems. Yes, every now and then that big blighter of a cargo plane comes in from Masa Matru and drops stuff off. We have friendly neighbors in the form of Pioneer Security who operate the Alexeni Airport near the Balur Railgun Ruins. Now, you should go check in. I'm going to bed. All play and no sleep makes Mrs. Arlberg's fair-haired lad a very dull flyer. Catch you around.
Well, well. Mr. Byrne. Nice to see you, buddy.
Hey, Herman. Fancy meeting you here.
Been a while, hasn't it?
Yeah, what is with Taranis and backcountry airstrips?
I remember being in one deep in central Queensland.
Well, everyone's gathered up right now in the meeting room. Our orientation, if you will, is about to start. Come on, I'll show you the way.
Welcome, Mr. Byrne. Just take a seat right over there. The commander will be briefing us all.
Hello, James.
Hey, Ash. It's nice to see you again. I mean, I wish I could see you personally, but that'll have to do.
I'm doing okay. This fresh new suit is much better.
Yes, I assume that you brought me all the way here for a reason. I mean, it was a lot of resources for just a simple catch-up.
I've seen your current predicament with the enemy. Those bastards are making the 3 moon safe at home.
Well, to be honest, I could have defended myself. Chris Windhover taught me very well. I wish he was here right now.
Windhover was a good man. He has indeed taught you very well. But Queensland is still a hot zone. It would be a strenuous effort to protect you.
But I am on board with Taranis. And it's always nice to have an adventure. So, what am I here for?
Here's the plan. Next stop is Poland. President Langhans will be two of us move out soon. We'll be heading to the 33rd Airbase near Polvich.
Poland? I was just getting used to this place.
Yes, but not right away. This is still our main base. As one of the experienced pilots of the Supervarks, we want you to help train a squadron for them.
The Supervarks? That's insane.
But why would we send a medium tactical bomber to Poland and... Never mind, I just answered my own question.
We're looking to bring them to Poland. You are a true leader, Byrne. It's just you haven't noticed. You've been through many battles and several armies. After your CAP mission, I knew you would do great things here.
Well, I have done my fair share of leading during the invasion, that's right, but doesn't mean it was very good.
I mean, they got everyone out in a hurry, but...
Don't worry about that. We can help you get up to speed. Your determination will be most helpful too.
Yes. I'm on board. I'll do it. Besides,
I have some old friends here, and I'm guaranteed to make some new ones. But with you, Herman, and everyone else, I know I can do it.
I will be your squadron leader.
That's the spirit. I know you can do it.
Welcome to Taranis.
Ukraine. When I was growing up here, this place seemed like a peaceful enough world where I could graduate from high school and achieve my dreams. But just before I graduated, it was consumed by death and destruction. A war with no victor and seemingly no end. In 2013, after the government had decided to suspend the Ukraine-European Union Association Agreement and seek closer economic ties with Russia, a several months long wave of demonstrations and protests known as the Euromaidan began, which later escalated into the 2014 Ukrainian Revolution that led to the overthrow of the president and the establishment of a new government. These events formed the background for the annexation of Crimea by Russia in March of that year, and the war in Donbass the following April. All we needed was support, reinforcement to turn back this illegal stealth invasion. Anything to pick up our beleaguered military and make them fight back. But that never came. The United States and NATO responded woefully, with nothing but sanctions and harsh words. Now here we are. 5 years, 13,000 dead, and 20 ceasefire attempts later. After graduation, I had planned to move to Kiev to study law. But now that is gone. I had made the decision to join the volunteers to hold back the invasion with my best friend. Now we've gone too far in the last 5 years. We will never be normal again.
Nazad Takskoro. Biotremali Bod Yagi Obid. Nibohato Vilzi Konflikto Nizmil Nohorazu. Simon Dursky Vidalenia Nibaye Shansi. Vajo Prayanamni Odin Tank T. Devyats Nosto. Kilka Vertoliti.
Mini Pavini Atakovati.
Shatemayus Ne Uvazi.
Znamikatos Sajabzia. Katos Moshe Topamoti. Boskoshe Sobni Mosral Vilele Znim.
Because of Topi. Nikto ni brighodit na topomoho.
Yavasise spodavayusia.
Sherezbiat rokov.
Ni vishito shenetak.
In a strange moment, and that's saying a lot for this war, we have a new helper from China. but it's better than nothing. There is a part of me that's desperate for changes. Part of me is scared we might not be strong enough. We were never standing on our own. We almost believed the other powers when they told us we were nothing on our own. They will listen when we say, I swear it here this minute, that we will not surrender.
Zojikaite, mi otri moyemo sinal.
Privyet, gospoda.
Kutonti.
Moshes nasivat menya svitko salut.
Salut kovatki evieto, problemia Yugoslav sik voin. Vabak evieto. Ili projekt desiat ostavlen.
Monsieur Estek.
Mi može pomoš nam?
Tebi nužna moja pomoš. I mi nužna tvoja pomoš. Rusija I Katai načinaju samrodne čate v Pikokacom region I centralnoj Aziji. No nas jes konkurujušije ostaki vrabak vnutri Rusi. I mi dožni ubeditija što oni ne predstavljaju u Rusi.
Druženi planov sojuznika ne ovšem družil vunin zest zaprošeni.
Я объясню это позже. Никто ты, чтобы российское вытащение прекратилось, да? Чтобы ваша страна не была свободной?
Стоят сухли о массивоем наспутлении.
Русские будут охотиться на нас, если вы поделились это, но... Да, это точно.
Тогда нам нужно помочь. У нас не будет шансов против того. Не то... Или что от нее осталось, не придет нам на помощь.
На самом деле, есть способ вовлечь Европу в бобу. У меня есть путь. Три пути.
Не слушаю.
Glad you're back with us, Infinity One. Let's get to it. The People's Republic of China and its allied forces have started making noise again. When the Second Iron War ended, the world's military forces were turned on their heads, giving China's allies access to plenty of weaponry and funding. The Pacific is still rebuilding. We cannot allow war to break out again. That's why I put in the request to have you assigned to our newly established Pacific Defense Forces. That look in your eyes tells me you haven't lost it. That's what I hoped. China's forces have commenced with activities all around the island chains. They cannot be allowed to expand their forces. That's where you come in, Infinity One.
First Tactical Fighter Wing, this is the New Horizons Control Tower. Do you copy? This is Omega 4. We hear you loud and clear. Over. Infinity One, you have permission to take off right after Omega 4. After takeoff, you'll be under command of AWACS Star Eye. Engage the intruding aircraft. Wind is 130 degrees at 15 knots. We are good to launch. Omega 4, you are cleared for takeoff. And roger. Airborne. AWACS Star Eye to all air units. You'll be under our command. Move to intercept. This could turn into a firefight. I hope these guys are the real deal. You'll find out soon enough. Everyone will. Radar lock on us! Bogies confirmed hostile. Engage! Dr. War! Waiting! Geisada! Atlas One engaging. Firing railgun. Direct hit.
Atlas One, change of plan. Move to intercept the enemy bomber force. Roger that. It is great to be back.
This is Viper 2. I've arrived on station and am aware of the situation.
Viper 2 and Rapier 1, assist Infinity 1.
Rapier 1 copies.
All aircraft rejoin formation.
This is Blue Flight, we are on station.
You're new here, so I'll fill you in. This guy's the real deal.
I can't stand old-timer pilots.
Such candor. Haven't you said too much, chap? I'll be the judge of that. I got a bandit on my tail. I'll shake him off.
Whoa, Dauntless One, you're crazy!
We're picking up something new on radar, same bearing as before. Hey, we come down, Wushan. We shan't be ma. Who can I?
Yeah, another one down.
Omega 4 here. Cali Bandits closing in on the shore. I'm moving to engage now.
Stop staring at Infinity One.
Digital G!
We're not picking up anything on radar. Mission accomplished. Good work. Well, I'll be. He's the real deal, alright. You know from fighting just once? Watch all you like. There will be more battles. Until then, we rest. Return to base.